everyone. This is Sharon Michaels of SharonMichaelsAuthor.com. And I was asked a question recently about why have I switched from nonfiction books to writing fiction books? And I thought that was a really good question. And I've made some notes because I don't want to miss anything. So I asked myself, is it time for a change? Is it time to do something different in my life? So I'm going to ask you the same question, because sometimes we're doing the same things over and over and over, and it's just comfortable. One of my goals was always to write fiction, and I realize I'm no Hemingway, but I enjoy writing fiction, and I've always wanted to do it, and I thought, why not? Why not do it? So I'm going to ask you a question. Is it time for a change? What I did is I looked at where I was right then. And I'm talking about my first nonfiction book that I wrote in 1996. And it's still available now in paperback and Kindle on Amazon. So you know I've been doing speaking engagements and writing nonfiction books for over 35 years. And a few years ago, I said to myself, is this what I want to keep doing? I mean, I'm not getting any younger. And one of my goals was to write fiction. So I said, what's making me happy? What brings me joy? And I looked inside and I said, what's working? What's not working? What brings me joy? What brings me happiness? And I want you to ask yourself the same question right now, because we're going through so many changes in our life, in our world, in our environment. Things are changing around us. And are you happy doing what you're doing? Do you feel content in what you're doing? Or has it become your comfort zone and you're ready to try something new? Spread your wings. Go for it. I want you to write an awesome goal this week, one that you've always had in the back of your mind, but you didn't know whether or not you had the nerve to go out and do it. So about 3 years ago, I wrote my first fiction book called The Prickly Pear Murder, and it's available on Kindle and paperback, and it was written as a memorial to our rescue dog Oscar, who had passed away a few years before that. And I realized it's probably not the best book in the world out there, but I wrote it with my heart, and I wrote it because it was a goal of mine, and I wrote it because I wanted to honor Oscar. And I did it because it was just the right time to do it. And that's what I'm asking you. Is this the right time to come out of your comfort zone and to do what you've been wanting to do? So now when I write my fiction, and I look today on Amazon, I have 25 short read fictions available and 10 nonfictions still available. So in my fiction stories, I feel like I'm still continuing my nonfiction writings that I've done, because my writing was all about goal setting, ending self-sabotaging behavior, giving yourself permission to succeed and live the life you want to live. So I looked at my fiction stories and I noticed there's a thread going through all of them. One, it's about empowered women. It's about lifting ourselves up and going for our goals. It's about learning a lesson. And in every one of my book, I realize I have some kind of a life lesson that the heroine has gone through and has conquered, or a challenge she's made happen for herself. And I want my fiction books to put a smile on your face. And I always want to give you a happy ending. So I've changed from nonfiction to fiction because it was just the right time in my life to do. But I still have my nonfiction available, and I still coaching clients. So I haven't given it up. It was just the right time to do something different and go for my goals. So I'm going to remind you, if you're not a subscriber to my Sharon Michaels Author newsletter, please do. The links are around here somewhere, depending on where you're watching this. And during the month of July, I am going to do a Facebook Live, and all my subscribers, I'm putting your name into a drawing, and I'm going to draw one name out to win any one of my paperbacks that I have. And again, I have, I think, 3 nonfiction paperbacks and 10 fiction paperbacks. And you can choose any one you want. I will sign it and mail it to you. So if you haven't subscribed to our newsletter, please do. And I want to remind you to go for your goals, stay safe, stay motivated, stay productive, and believe in yourself, because I know you can do it. And this is the time to go for your goals and to make those dreams reality. So thank you so much for asking the questions. Keep the questions coming and have an empowered, beautiful day. And please remember that I believe in you, and this is the time to go for your goals.